Hi, and welcome to this next video in the series of the hardest GCSE problems of all time. Now, in case you're outside of the UK, GCSEs are exams that students in England and Wales take when they're about 16 years old. And these questions we're exploring in these videos are particularly notoriously hard problems that a very small percentage of students nationally got correct. So let's read this question. The two triangles in the diagram are similar. And in case you don't know what this word similar means in a mathematical context, it means that we have two triangles which are the same shape, but just maybe different sizes. So, for example, if I drew like a triangle like this, and then, If we had a triangle like this, and then a bigger triangle like this, we can see that these are the kind of same shape, but they're just one is bigger than the other. And if we say the same shape, we also say that they have to have the same angle. So this angle we say is the same as this one, and this top one is the same as this top one, and the other angle is the same as well. So these two triangles, same shape, different sizes, we say they are similar. So we've got these two triangles here, and the triangles you see is like this smaller one here, that's one of the triangles, and then we've got this bigger triangle here, the whole thing. So we're saying that triangle is the same shape as that one there. And we're told there are two possible values of x. So this value of x here has two possible values, and we're gonna work out what those values are. Now, what makes this question particularly hard is it seems really weird that there's two possible values of x. Surely that if we've got this triangle here and this triangle here, that's just one possible length, right? And that's what makes this question particularly difficult, I think. Now, let's think how we would usually tackle similar triangles to kind of work out what x might be. So if we have these two triangles here, let's just say that we had, some lengths down here of, let's say that's 2, and let's say that was 6. Then what we could do is, because this side of the triangle is comparable to this side of this triangle, we can look at the scale factor. How many times bigger is this triangle getting? Well, we can see it's 3 times bigger. And the way we got that scale factor is just do 6 divided by 2, the second number divided by the first number, and that gives you the scale factor. Now, with similar triangles or any similar shapes, all the lengths scale in the same way. So, for example, if I had a bottom length here of 4, then that's got a scale in the same way, the same scale factor, which we said it was 3, and that gives you 12. So, in general, the scale factor is always the same. So we could say, for example, this number, this length divided by this length is going to be the same as this length divided by this length, because that scale factor is going to be 3. And if we make it more general, so if I just rub out this scale factor here, rub out this length, rub out this length, rub out this length, rub out this length, and rub out that, then let's say in general, we've got a length here of A and we've got a length B. Then what's the scale factor? Well, I said we do the second length divided by the first length. So we do the B divided by A. So that scale factor is B over A. And then let's say these lengths are C and D. Then what's the scale factor? Well, it's going to be the second number divided by the first, D over C. Now, as I said, that scale factor for all different pairs of lengths is always going to be the same if they're similar. So we can say that B over A is equal to D over C. And that's a really important property of similar triangles that we can use here. So let's just put a big box around that. There we go. There we go. Let's even straighten it. Brilliant. Okay, so let's now apply that to these triangles here. Now, I'm going to first assume that with this triangle here, it's the same kind of orientation, the same way up as this larger triangle here, right? So what I'm saying is basically that, okay, this angle is common, this angle at the bottom is common to both triangles, the smaller one, the bigger one. But I'm going to say that this top angle here, the smaller triangle, is the same as the top angle of this triangle here. So the triangles are the same way up, it's just scaled like that, right? Now, what I find helpful to do is to draw out the two separate triangles with their lengths, so we can then use this kind of formula here. So let's look at these two triangles. Let's do the triangle ABE. So we're going to draw it over here. ABE. There we go. It's nice and straightened. So we've got the lengths of 8 and 12. I'm not going to bother writing the units in this first triangle. And then the bigger one, so we do the whole thing. And that bottom length, we can see of the big triangle, that's 12 plus 3, which is 15. So let's put the 15 there. And then we've also got this whole length here of the big triangle, which is x plus 8. It's the sum of those two, x plus 8. So let's put that on here. So we've got x plus 8. And as I say, I'm assuming that like this angle is the same as this, and this top one's the same as this top one. So the triangle is enlarged, but it hasn't flipped over, for example. So let's use the principle above. We're going to say that this length divided by this one, so 15 divided by 12, is the same as this length divided by this one, the same scale factor, so x plus 8 over 8. Now, when we have a fraction equal to a fraction, we can do something called cross multiplication. So we can say that this times this is equal to this times this. We can always do that when we have a fraction equals a fraction. So we're going to do 15 times 8 is equal to 12 times x plus 8. And what is 15 times 8? Well, 15, you double again. So 30, 60, 120 is equal to that 12 times x is 12x. We're expanding out the brackets. And 12 times 8 is 96. And then if we subtract that 96, 24? So we've got 24 equals 12x. And then divide both sides by 12, we get x is equal to 2. And it's in centimetres, isn't it? So this x up here, this x here, could be 2 centimetres. So how do we get another value of x? Now, this is where it gets a bit weird. But basically, we weren't told at any point that this length here is parallel to this one. Because usually with GCSE questions or other kind of exams, that when you have one triangle embedded inside another, you're going to assume that these lengths, they kind of look parallel, and they would actually tell you they're parallel. But they might not be. It might be actually that with our triangles, this triangle here is flipped upside down to get this one here. So in fact, if I rub out this angle at the top, rub out this. Sorry, just getting my rubber to work. It might be that this angle here actually corresponds to this angle here, because basically the triangle is flipped upside down. So this angle here becomes this one here, and this angle here becomes this one here, because it's flipped over as it's enlarged. Yep. So now we're going to draw the triangles again, but the other way around. So if I draw the triangles on the next page, so the smaller one I'm just going to say is the same. So we've got the 8 and we've got the 12. And now if we draw our bigger one that's similar to it, and again, I'm going to use the same angles, I'm actually going to flip it over. So we want the side length that's between this single marked angle and the double marked angle here. If we look on the diagram, we can see it's actually this one now, because it's flipped upside down. So this 15 here is actually here. So let's put the 15 there. And then the other one is just going to be the x plus 8 again. But you can see, if we compare these two diagrams, basically I've flipped that bigger triangle upside down. So the x plus 8 is here. It's now down here. The 15 was down here. It's now up here. So this is the kind of flipped triangle version. So we're going to do the same thing again. We're going to do 15 over 8. So 15 over 8 is equal to x plus 8 over 12. And we're going to do a similar thing in terms of just cross multiply. So we do 15 times 12 is 8 times x plus 8. So if we do that, if I write that 15 times 12, and I'm going to write 8 times x plus 8. So what is 15 times 12? I hope it's 180, doing it in my head. And then we expand these brackets. 8 times x is 8x. 8 times 8 is 64. And then we subtract the 64, 116 equals 8x. And then we divide both sides by 8. So we get 116 over 8, which is 58 divided by 4. which is 29 divided by 2. We could leave it like that, or we could give it as a decimal, so it's 14.5 centimetres. The reason why I don't really like this exam question, I think it's sort of, it's hard, but it also is a bad question, is because if you just look at this diagram, like, it's the trouble is, like, imagining it the other way around would actually sort of change the diagram. So if you're saying that this is the same way up as this triangle, then you can't sort of suddenly imagine a different diagram where it's actually flipped over. And also, just looking at the sort of these lengths, if x is 14.5, I suppose it could look right, but it's just, I kind of find that sort of flipping the triangle a bit weird. Anyway, that's the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed it, and please do like and subscribe if you did enjoy it.